The shores of the Caspian Sea hold a bizarre sight, a colossal 380-ton machine seemingly beached like a beached whale. This is the Lun-class Ekranoplan, a marvel of Soviet engineering and the last of its kind. A hybrid of airplane and ship ekranoplans, also known as ground effect vehicles, GEVs, defy easy categorization. They skim the water's surface, harnessing the ground effect, an aerodynamic principle that generates lift due to the proximity to the ground, or water in this case. This allows them to fly much faster than conventional ships, yet lower than airplanes. Imagine a giant winged speedboat that can take off and land in rough seas. A Cold War Leviathan, the Lun, nicknamed the Caspian Sea Monster during the Cold War, was a product of the Soviet military's ambition. Its massive size, exceeding that of an Airbus A380 Super Jumbo jet, housed eight powerful turbofan engines that propelled it to speeds of up to 550 kilometers per hour, 340 miles per hour. Armed with six anti-ship missiles, it was designed for lightning-fast sea attacks, a stealthy predator lurking just above the waves. The Lun-class Ekranoplan was a massive and imposing aircraft with a unique design. Picture a sleek, boat-like fuselage sitting atop a pair of large, stubby wings. The fuselage was elongated and streamlined, resembling the hull of a ship, allowing it to skim over the water's surface. The wings were positioned near the middle of the fuselage and swept back at a slight angle. It was approximately 73 meters, 240 feet in length, with a wingspan of about 44 meters, 144 feet. Its eight turbofan engines arranged in a row along the length of the aircraft. These engines were enclosed within nacelles for protection and were designed to provide the necessary thrust for both lift and propulsion. At the rear of the aircraft, there were multiple tail fins and rudders, which helped with stability and control during flight. The cockpit featured large windows for visibility. The Lun-class Ekranoplan was designed by the Central Hydrofoil Design Bureau in the Soviet Union. The mastermind behind the design was Rostislav Alexeyev, considered the chief designer of this project. Unfortunately, pinpointing the exact development time for the Lun-class Ekranoplan is a bit tricky. Here's why. The foundation for the Lun likely began with earlier Ekranoplan projects spearheaded by Alexeyev. Development of Ekranoplans in the Soviet Union traces back to at least the 1960s, with the KM, sometimes referred to as the Caspian Sea Monster, being a notable predecessor. While a clear starting point for the Lun's design isn't readily available, sources indicate it was designed by Rostislav Alexeyev in 1975. Following the design phase, construction likely took place in the late 1970s or early 1980s. The Lun finally entered service in 1987, so while there isn't a single definitive time frame for the Lun's development, it likely spanned over a decade. This includes Alexeyev's earlier Ekranoplan work, the specific design of the Lun class, and its eventual construction and deployment. The Lun's development by the Soviet Navy stemmed from several strategic considerations during the Cold War era. Ekranoplans offered a significant speed advantage over traditional warships. The Lun's ability to skim the water's surface at speeds exceeding 550 kilometers per hour made it ideal for launching swift and unexpected attacks on enemy vessels. Operating at a very low altitude above the Caspian Sea significantly reduced the Lun's radar signature. This feature offered a crucial tactical advantage in surprise attacks and potentially lessened its vulnerability to enemy countermeasures. Unlike conventional ships that could be hampered by rough seas, the Lun's design leveraged the ground effect to enable takeoff and landing in relatively choppy waters. This ensured operational effectiveness in a wider range of weather scenarios. Equipped with six anti-ship missiles, the Lun served as a formidable offensive weapon within the Caspian Sea theater. Its ability to combine speed, stealth, and offensive firepower made it a significant addition to the Soviet Navy's arsenal, from war machine to tourist attraction. Following the Soviet Union's collapse, the Lun program was scrapped and the sole completed Lun was left to rust at a naval base. However, its unique design has sparked renewed interest. In 2020, it was painstakingly moved to Derbent, Russia, where it's destined to become the centerpiece of a planned Patriot Park, a military museum and theme park. A star before its time. Despite delays in the park's construction, the Lun has already become a tourist magnet. Its photogenic strangeness and historical significance have drawn crowds, with some enterprising souls even sneaking in for a closer look. Lun is not just a relic. It represents a technology with potential for a peaceful future. Ekranoplans, a revival in the making? While the Lun might be a Cold War warrior, Ekranoplans as a concept are experiencing a resurgence. Developers worldwide, including those in Singapore, the United States, China, and Russia, are working on reviving this technology for civilian applications. Perhaps the future holds quieter, more eco-friendly Ekranoplans skimming the waves for commercial purposes or passenger transport. The Lun's story is one of innovation, military might, and potential rebirth. As it waits for its museum debut, it serves as a reminder of the ingenuity of human engineering and the enduring allure of the unusual.